Hey, what's up guys, Jewish Commentator here, bringing you guys a new video, and this is a tutorial or a walkthrough for the Spec Ops mission, Fire Mission, on Veterans. So this is one of the most challenging missions in Call of Duty history, and today I'll show you how to beat it. So, it's not that hard, but there are a couple of things you want to focus on. So, the main thing you want to focus on is the AC-130. The best player should be the AC-130 gunner, because pretty much the AC-130 does all the work. So if you're good with the AC-130 and your friend is alright with the AC-130, you should probably be using the AC-130. As you can see here, there's a lot of strategies that you need to do, and I'll show you how to do that now. So first of all, zoom in, zoom out. Zooming in and zooming out helps you get more accurate targets and also acquire and kill more people in a shorter amount of time. So as you see here, I zoom in, zoom out, zoom in, zoom out, so I can kill more people and also get accurate shots in. Now, to take out choppers, you want to use the small minigun or the 25mm machine gun. It's around like a one-hit kill and then they die, so that's also nice. The big gun, you don't really want to use it too much, only for the beginning to take out the two cars, and that's pretty much that. You mainly want to use the main machine gun and I guess the small minigun. And you see here I'm zooming in, zooming out so I can get more targets. For the choppers, you don't want to be zoomed in too much because sometimes they move. So you kind of want to be halfway zoomed in, not all the way zoomed in, and not all the way zoomed out. For the big gun, you want to be zoomed in all the way so you see who you're hitting. You don't want to hit your teammates. Now before we go over to the guy on the ground, there are like a couple of things that you should know when you're in the AC-130. One, you can kill your teammates, so be careful. Two, when you get to 30 seconds, more people spawn in. And that's really key. You want to make sure that you take out everyone before your guy gets out of the little basement there. And you'll see what I mean in a second. See how many guys just spawned in from the ground. Also, you want to take out the guys on the rooftops in the beginning, because those are the hardest for your guy to kill on the ground. And they're pretty much almost invincible for the person on the ground. So you really want to make sure that you just kill them. Alright, so those were tips for the AC-130, and now for the guy on the ground. So first of all, you want to just jump down on this little pipe thing and just shoot and press LT, 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 or just to aim, and this will pretty much do aim assist and hurt your enemies, and it will also show your enemies to the AC-130 guy because of your laser. So you just want to do that in the beginning, just do auto aim, more aim assist, and it will help. You can also highlight targets for the AC-130 guy with your laser, so you kind of want to do that. Good communication is key. Now when you're on the ground and you're around 80 meters away, there should be a little rooftop to your left with an explosive barrel on it. You want to make sure that you take it out because there's going to be a guy there. And that guy is pretty much the reason you won't succeed in the mission. He will stay alive and he will try to hunt you down. He is very, very good, I guess. He's a very smart AI and I guess he's going to kill you. So make sure you take out the guy on the rooftop. He will be very annoying. Now for the route you take, you want to make sure that you take the right side and you're always behind cover. And also make sure the AC-130 guy is taking out the cars that I just passed, because those cars can also stop you. And also you want to make sure that you throw flashbangs that will help you. So once you get to the door, plant a C4, get a flashbang ready, and then just throw a flashbang in the room and take out all the guys over there. This flashbang will help you because in close quarter combat, you want to make sure that you take out everyone and that you don't get shot like I do here. Alright, so once you get to the laptop, just make sure you don't waste any time, because I almost ran out of time there and that would have sucked. So it worked. Now you want to make sure that you get out of this little barn or basement thing, and then you get immediate cover as fast as you can, and that you want to watch your back because there will be people there. If your AC-130 guy is good enough, he will make sure to take him out like he does here. And also there's going to be a lot of people in the front, so I guess your AC-130 guy should be very, very good and very, very fast. Zoom in, zoom out, and take out those guys behind you, guys on the roof, and guys right in front of you. Once he does that, he should say all clear and you should run. Now remember, in 30 seconds, more people spawn in, so you kind of want to take advantage of those extra times that you have. So as you see here, I get there really quickly, and I unlock the main entrance. So like I said before, communication is key. You want to make sure that your gunner tells you when to move and when to not, because your gunner is pretty much your like pimp, and he's gonna save your ass whenever you need him to. And lastly, for this final part here, you just wanna blow the shit out of him and you just wanna run. For this part, all you gotta do is just touch down on that little checkpoint and then you're saved. So I made it 3 seconds earlier, and as you can see, I only got 9 kills for this whole game, and my AC-130 gunner got 84 kills. Of course, this is on Veteran, and this has been another Jewish Commentator video. So if I helped you guys, give this video a thumbs up, and if you want more tutorials, make sure to subscribe. I hope you guys can do this now, and I hope I helped. Alright guys.